please welcome back to the Elder Scrolls Daggerfall. Today's task at hand is to grant up the next level of the knightly order of, you know, basically the Knights of the Rose. And right now we are the modifications here. So we're basically a knight brother. I thought I was a keeper. What happened? Yeah, never mind. I was being a dum-dum. Apparently, I was promoted to keeper first, with my first promotion. Next one was knight brother. So right now, we need to get to the next rank, which I think... I forgot what the next rank is. I just read about it. But anyway, let's go ahead and get a quest from this old guy. Grimfangs, we have an emergency. The Mage's Guild has discovered a rift in the wall between Oblivion and our dimension, Mundus. I don't pretend to understand exactly what he means, but it's bad. All sorts of dangerous beings are entering into our world. The Mage's Guild says it can seal the breach, but it falls to us to slay the Daedras that have already crossed over. Will you take up this quest, not for gold, but for glory? Now, this is something I'm a little nervous about. I should have probably saved it before I rolled for this quest. I suppose so. I'm typically not the kind of person to lose a quest. So, yeah, and this one seems important. This one seems like it could threaten all of Tamriel, to be honest. So, yeah, let's go ahead and do this quest, address this quest. Go quickly to the Hold of Mastercroft. We have no way of knowing how many Daedra are wandering its halls. The Mage Skill says to slay all Daedra beings you encounter. They will contact you by spell when they detect the last invader gone. Hurry, for in 27 days it will be too late. Hold of Mastercroft. Alright, yet another dungeon crawl. I mean, the dungeon crawling in this game could have been so much better if it wasn't for the ridiculously long dungeons. Why do these two look like Daedra seducers? Huh. Anyway. Let me just go ahead and pull out my Daedric sword for the special occasion. I'm gonna pull out the wagon and move this to the wagon. And I'm basically gonna equip my Daedric sword. That should help. So I presume. Hold of Mastercroft. Here we go. No, ships don't travel on the land. We have to use our horse. Okay. We have been given 27 days. I think the statue lies in the dust. Time to equip the sword. And time to get the moving. That seems like it could be an entry point, but logic says that it should be somewhere over here in this vicinity. I think this is it. Let me go ahead and make a save. Not gonna make the same mistake twice. I have silenced? What does that mean? Oh, that was a day drop? That was easy. For some reason, I thought that this guy would be far more difficult to deal with. But yeah, I mean, talk about that, like, entering a dungeon only to get assaulted right off the bat. And I do not think there are any hidden doors here. The atmospheres of these dungeons are also like superbly done. Should I save here? No, I don't think I need to. Come on, it's not going to be for me, seriously. So it's basically a day trot hunting quest, and I can see a few bees there to go. I think I've been to this module before, this specific module. It was part of the main quest, the Beowulf quest, I think. Not Beowulf quest, no, one of the quests after that. The letters? Yeah, the letters would be now B. So which one should we go now? I think I would take the right. Yeah, let me just go ahead and drop something here. Just to note the fact that I have been here. Should we go that way or this way? And that is a big question. If I'm not wrong, this should also be like a hidden door somewhere on this wall here. Yep, right here. So, should we access the hidden door first, or should we just follow the moon path first? And our job is to go ahead and lead as many Daedra as we can, and Daedra as well, so. Here's to hoping that I don't find any Daedra that are too difficult. I have no idea what this thing is. A monk with a weapon? Yeah, not a really good monk, if you ask me. I'll be moving both boss, maybe the gold pieces. And that's all we have. Too bad. I'll make a save here. Just to be safe. Mm-hmm. Okay. I'll come back to you later. I'll mark this area with something. With a dragon. Underwater area, I'm not going there. Hooray! I recently found out that these guys are also mutable. I did not know that they were mutable before. Yeah, the cube systems always confound me in this game. Okay, at least this path leads nowhere. So we can strike this off our left, off our list, excuse me. Now to go here. If we drop some blood here. I don't know how I'm carrying that blood, but yeah, I do have some blood here. So apparently these Daedras like to silence me for whatever matters. Maybe that is like a measure against spellcasters. Potion of levitation, yeah, I don't think I want that. Iron longsword. Common symbol. Yeah. But then again, it is what. Light. So, I'm just gonna rest here and don't really yield. Because these guys seem to take a chunk out of your health, I'm just gonna save again. And save scanning is the proper way to play these games, Arena and Daggerfall. And I think we see somebody over there, so I'll just go ahead and tackle that person first. They do not seem to be aware of my presence yet. And I wonder if it is because I'm silenced at the moment. Another monk. I wonder if I need to go through all these monks like that. Why these monks are so combative in the first place? Another thing there, I'll drop another thing here. I'm afraid this dungeon might just be a little confusing. They drop that. So basically, if I'm silenced, I probably can't cast spells, is what I'm thinking, is the intended result of silencing somebody. Straight or to the left? Let's go straight. I mean, I'll get to Lua as soon as all the Daedras are dead. That's a mummy. Thank you for coming. These guys even have lots of gold, so that is something that I like. Somebody will do something? What the f? Where the hell did you come from? I'll take the gold, and what else do you have to offer? Iron boots. Elven stuff. Now that is something that I can sell for money. So, although it will not fetch me like a pretty penny, but it will fetch me something. Oh, okay, there's like a second room in here. I completely missed that, to be honest. So my cough issue is getting a little worse, as you can probably tell. And yeah, that's keeping me from shouting for the recording, as I usually must. Probably should have rested here. but it's fine. I can probably just use this hoe. Also, as you are not new, to be honest. That's a Daggerfall. Another Daggerfall. That looks like a golden, to be honest. That's like a Daggerfall from Golden, not really. On our team, we've drawn something. Your enemies nearby. But here's the thing. First off, I would like to drop something here. This thing should be good. And secondly, I would like to go here and rest. There are some enemies nearby. Maybe you can rest and go. So I hope. Oh, there are still enemies in here. Okay, where did I? I was confused about where that body is. There are still enemies nearby. What about that destruction? Enemies nearby. Enemies nearby. Enemies nearby. So it sounds like the enemies can visit us. Yeah, that sounds like, this is a good place to rest, I think. Wrong blade has improved, that is very good. I should be leveling up soon. I'll save the game here. I just wish that the game also had it, like a feature where you could like grab a torch and illuminate the way for yourself, so that it would actually not be as dark in all of these areas. So which way did we go again? We didn't go far, to be honest here. Another data. These guys hit hard. I mean, these guys aren't as difficult as the other ones, but these guys hit hard. Possible. I'll remove them, I guess. I'll save the game and save the hole. And yeah, since this door was open for us, let's just busy through it. Some more blood dropped to the ground. Oh, one of these rooms, right. Where would it not be? Just out of there. I can see a D-drop down there, so I guess let's go ahead and kill it. Scour the area until there are no more D-drops remaining is the objective of this incursion. These guys hit hard. These guys hit really hard. 500 gold pieces. I feel like I'll be too overwhelmed to carry anything shortly because of how hard these guys hit. Uh-oh, there's like this. I'm guessing the last daydrop is somewhere down there, and we need to figure out how to open that mechanism up. And I'm pretty sure that the part that we saw up there was the way to get here. It seems like a lot of the dungeons share some of these common modules. Well, let's drop some blood again, which is ironically in this sack this time around. Lots of gold and stuff inside it. Yeah, so that's the way into the trapdoor. Question now is, how do we open the dungeon? I can hear a lot of objectionable stuff in there. Should I? Let me make a save first. So that if people prefer to open the store up. It's a monk. The monks are using some sort of ranged weapon to attack him, which is strange because I've never heard of a monk who uses ranged weapon. Super more. Ooh, some loot. Is this heavy? Whoa, holy dagger, 2500 gold? Yeah, I'm taking that. Let's not accidentally drop something. There are enemies nearby, too bad I can't miss the rest here. Otherwise that would have been like a convenience almost. Yeah, I do not expect there to be any hidden doors here. Just this access point over there. And yeah, I guess we can clear this area out too. What just happened? So this is lever here. I think we need to activate this. Because it does something in the dungeon. Like, sort of one thing that you can follow in Daggerfall would be surprised is if you find a button, try flipping it. But of course, save before you do, because otherwise you might wait on standing on top of the wave. But that could have been like a very bad thing for me, because these guys, sometimes you can get trapped underneath them. And I don't think there is anything behind this panel, though, there isn't. I would move to grab mode instead of dialogue mode. I can hear something else. I don't know what exactly it is, but I can definitely hear something else. I'm assuming this takes me. I don't know where it takes me. But it seems we have been before, whatever this is. Oh, okay, alright. So this is this place where we found them. Right. Okay, so. Let's just go run right back and rest in that area. Good thing we can rest here now. There are enemies nearby, really? Oh, mama. See, play more. Let's keep resting in that area for the lead. Better to not take anything for granted. Yeah. So, now we need to figure out how to open that damn door. I'll just quickly go check it. I don't think it's the lever that did the trick. There's probably something else. But still, nonetheless, I will check it once. Pretty sure the thing that I can hear down there, the trapdoor is the ghost. Pretty sure the thing that I can hear is coming from that trapdoor down there. And let us stop running so much and let's keep moving. I see a daydrop. I am silenced. Why do these guys hit so hard? My god. I mean, it would be practically impossible for me to. Daedric is improved on his stealth. My god. That is indeed nice. Good thing I could rest there right after defeating Daedric, otherwise, I could have found myself in a sticky situation. Yeah, I don't know whether I want to go in here or go down. Okay, let's go in here first. Yeah, see, that's what I'm talking about. These dungeons are mostly non-linear. So, another mark. And it pushes them back. That's something that I really appreciate. Iron. The way that it pushes them back. So, plus 5 for the raven. Plus 1, of course. Difficult to find the plus. A 6 armor rating though, to be honest. I had to struggle a lot just to find the plus 4 armor rating though. Plus 5 though. I think I got it as part of the quest, Knightly Order, so yeah. Yeah, I'm not going up down there right now. Are there any hidden doors here? None that I can tell. Yeah, let me pick this up here. Let me pick this up from here, and since the door is open, that sort of marks the fact that I have already been down here. And I'll maybe pick this here, and somehow maybe pick this here, because we're now covering this side. Should I see? Maybe I should. I haven't seen anything wrong. This is. I don't know where this goes on from. Oh, hi, Daedric. Is it, would these guys die if they just sort of crumpled into themselves? Look at this, this guy looks like a frog right now. They've got a frog. Nothing more, nothing less. The cheap imitation of a frog. So, okay, that does it. I've covered both areas. Both sections of this side. Let's drop some flowers here, which are contained in a. Looks like we also dropped a sword and a kite shield and a buckler on top of that. I wonder where these are useful. I mean, all I wanted to drop is a flower. Let's keep moving. Okay, it's a knock. Are we like chanting or something? Why can I feel like a moon? Who is that? An adamantium beast. That's. Yeah, about as much. Let me put this into his inventory. Oh, really? Is there anything that I drop at? I do not suppose so. I think I'm just carrying way too much goons to be able to carry that thing. I can't carry that. That's sad. That's really sad. How much gold is this? 550? Yeah, I think this would be a better deal than the Elven stuff. But I am actually glad to know that there are things like Elven stuff that you can get in this game. Are there any hidden doors? There seems to be one. Yeah, right here. Let me save. I think I'm saving a lot more than I was previously. Excuse me. This is the door, yes? Oh no, wait. I'm inside the door. It is locked. Do I need to be like standing square in front of me or something? To bash open this door? Oh, hi there. I mean, you're not threatening me and you're not a target, so I'm just going to let you go. Unless you start firing arrows at me, in which case I'll be pissed. You're not doing that, right? Good, you can say that. There's a puppy in the middle. I mean, I call it a puppy, I don't know what it is. I think this is the door. The mob has nothing to fear from me. Until, of course, I start swinging my sword. Then we'll be covering and gone. I think this is. Yep. Not as much. Okay, time to go back. I'm not gonna take a long way around here. But at least let me go ahead and save the game here so that. I can demarcate the fact that, we have explored all of this area. This entire module seems so familiar to the last dungeon that we went into. I even forgot which. Yeah. The quest for Mynisera's letters. Not Mynisera's letters, but. I mean, I guess. Draw the letters that Mynisera was just displeasing from. Looks like I'm part of storage space. You know. Now that I know about this shortcut, might as well just go and just deposit some of my stuff. Where was it again? Ah, this way. Yes. So we walked in the drop. Maybe we can move this along and the wand. Because I don't know what to do. Oh no, that's not what I wanted to do at all. I did make that mistake every single time I play this dungeon apparently. Is there anything that I said I can drop from my long supreme skull? I could put my back in the packet. Let's see. Yeah, I don't think I can. I mean, we are over encumbered and most of it is like gold. 10,000 pieces of gold, I should drop zero. Okay, I guess it'll have to stay this way. Hope it does here, that would be good. And then we'll be back on our way. Let me update this here save. I'll be talking to you later. Now, the only disadvantage to not keeping this person is the fact that we can't rest here, for sure part. Because if we had killed that person, then yeah, we would have easily been able to rest there. But since we haven't done that, it would be difficult for us to rest if we want to. Should we choose to leave it? We cleared this robot, there was another day drop there. See, when we set an AR data, we would have been here before. No, why is this door open then? Ominous. Oh my god, it's an entire... It's a welcome party. No. Wait. Does being silenced mean being invisible? Because... Yeah, that intro just looks sort of disengaging from time to time. And I cannot believe how smoothly that turned out. I did not expect that to turn out as smoothly. Oh no, I want this. Ebony fail. Then again, I mean, I'm only gonna be able to sell it for like what? I could carry 610 gold, but I could not carry the gold that this guy had, seriously? Okay. This game is weird from time to time. Be missing any rows perhaps? I cannot see any. So I guess we must not. Except for this one real quick. So yeah, if the design is the same as the previous dungeon, then pushing this forward sort of well. Let's see if I up there. Which we'll be checking out later. I'm not gonna check out that path right now. That module. So yeah, it was like all three of them sort of decided to band together and ambush me in the welcome part. We can also drop down from here, which is also again something that I'm not looking forward to, because I think this is just one of the ways that we can come down from. If we would probably drop down in one of the areas that we've already previously visited. So yeah, let's keep moving and because I've played the strategy module before and in most cases you don't really... I wish I had the bracelet of box strength still with me, because that would have been really helpful in these situations. I hear no enemies and all of a sudden, and what is that? Sounds like a rustling of leaves. I just hope that I'm not getting double times by multiple Daedra. I mean, they said Daedra was expecting more powerful, so like people that were more powerful, but yeah, these guys are powerful in their own right too. That's a mummy. My backstab will definitely be worth this. And it's sort of pointless to try and loot corpses in here at this point, because it's supposed to be like a door there which hits me here. Let's pick up. I missed this door. It's sort of my bad, but because see, the thing about this door is... Yeah, there's nothing here, as usual. It lets you move this pedestal to the side. It is now more to the right. Now what that does for you is that it lets you jump over into this area and access more parts of the dungeon. None of them lead anywhere, but you can now access more parts of the dungeon. So, wish me luck. Yep, done. No, I can actually jump that far without ever moving this, but it gets a little tricky. I mean, it sort of does need a precision platformer. So yeah, I just prefer doing it like this. Oh, yes! Okay, so Vilbar apparently edits a little more better research, and Vilbar apparently does search for us. So, strength, endurance. Willpower really does not help us in... Well... mitigating the damage of spells, so it really isn't that useful for us at all. So I'm guessing at this point all we should be doing is focusing on strength, endurance, and speed. I think I should upgrade my speed loop, because that seems to be the most advanced out of all. As far as I'm concerned, at least. Yeah. Let me rest again. That's what I need. Good. And let's save this game in. Now, this room was one tricky place previous time around. See, the thing is, as soon as I touch this statue, and that is the only way to do it, but as soon as I touch the statue, okay. Yeah, it's like, I'll get assaulted by all of these guys. Are there more there? Oh, he has that treasure. Okay. I can... another way. Of course, this one that assault is a striker. Does this get another one of the treasure? I'm silenced by that Daedrot. Come on. Why are you moving away? So the staggered strategy apparently works. Why do you even bother? But yeah, unless you're using breaker, good thing is I have got potions of reaction with me. Pure poison, should I? Yeah, might as well. I think my strength is also increased. I did increase my strength. So that should let me carry a little bit more loot. And yeah, this is the room with the secret. The secret room. Not the room with the secret stuff, but rather the secret room. Not really. That's a scorpion singer. That important. There's also like a loot pile in here. So, okay. I've been to this module before. It's previous dungeon also had the same module. And yeah. That. Yeah, let's go there. Where's the PC? So, I had a rough time in the previous dungeon when I was trying this out because, oh, hi, Vape. You actually managed to hit me. Good job. Congratulations. Possibly not having a pressure. Why the problem? Oh, yeah, I'm gonna take this knife. Oh, of course I can't. 2500 gold. Should I drop like 85? Two pieces so that I can pick up this knife for 2500 gold. Yes, thank you. I will do that. And I do not believe there are any hidden chambers here that I can access. No, there are not. So, yeah, that's pretty much all this room is about. And at this point, I feel like I've cleared out a significant portion of this dungeon already. Now, it is time to head all the way back. So, the question now is, should we use the shortcut or not? Because that seems to be the most sensible option, to be honest. Instead of going all the way back, might as well just use the shortcut, because I do not think there are any pieces in between that we have left unexplored. Did I save it? Let me go ahead and do the same again. In case I did not. Let's take longer on the... I like how the character moves faster. Whenever, you know, you're sort of maybe wanted people going this way. So, we did not explore this area. Might as well go here then. We'll come back to that other side later. Could be that this is someplace we wanted to enter. See, the game is structured in a way where we don't really have to explore like every nook and cranny of every single. This guy shot me. I was not expecting him. This guy's like, surprise, motherfucker. but yeah. The game is designed and structured in such a way that you don't need to really explore every nook and cranny of the dungeon. I mean, usually secret areas don't really contain mission objectives, even if it is not a kill quest like this, and more like just an option. So, a quest to search for objects. Well, it is going to save it again. I know I'm saving a lot, but Sieve's Coming is the way to win arena. My god, this is huge. Log in between. Oh, hi, Petra. I was looking for one of you. What is this? Pain ropes, of course. Resist fire, not something that I need. Long shield, we've gone on. Cool pieces, of course, I can't carry that. I cannot even carry that. Okay, let me drop an ingredient here. Let me try picking up that Unicorn Horn now. I think I should be able to get it. Okay. No, fine. Never mind. Campfire lit. I see somebody over there. And that guy's actually shooting at me. Maybe they'll teach him a lesson to not shoot at strangers. Especially as a monk. This guy had like such a diverse variety of weapons. I mean, I guess monks are a martial class at the end, so. Should I save it? Mayhaps. Mayhaps I should. Ah, it's a welcoming party. That is unaware of me. The guy opened the door only for him to show his back that bit. I heard two doors opening, I don't know where they were opened. I just hope they weren't open. Ah, they were open behind me. Wait a minute. Okay, where is the secret doorway? It's supposed to be over here somewhere? Yes, it is. Ah, see? Maybe these guys come to you. You don't even need to go to them. But yeah, it's like, these guys are getting all quits on me. Which is something that I cannot understand. But neither understand nor appreciate. Looks like there's another one of these modules here. For us to access. I think we hear some giants. Of course, I only think. I don't know for certain. Do not specifically need that, but I would like to update the savior. Hi there, I was looking for one of you guys. So that's what you guys sound like, huh? Chain boots, too bad I got neutral ones. Of course I cannot carry that. Good. I guess I'll just press here. Long blade is improved. Save game. I'll change the save slot to this one. And that was it for this. I do not know what's making all those noises, but something is making all those noises. And yeah. No secret doors or anything. We'll be revisiting all of these areas in case we have covered the entirety of the dungeon and have failed to find any last two or five remaining teardrops or whatever. Because after all, this is Daggerfall, and making something easy is not really in the vocabulary. There is something over there. There are three ways here. I did not figure that out. Oh, I did. And the path punches a few further, and I can see a giant skull there on the ground. Why do you even bother? Well, in the hopes that I find something worth selling, I suppose. Yep, interacting with this does nothing. And I guess I'll just let's save it. Why not? Well, that's it. Yeah, this seems to be blocked off. There's a door here. And I do not believe there's a secret door here either. Let's see this side. Daggerfall! Come here, buddy! Come to die. Yeah, I don't know how to use words in this situation. It's not that I can buy my way out of this dungeon. But to empty trots leave. That begs the question, why do all these daytrots even have goals with them? I mean, what use do they have with their goals? It's not like there's like an entire commercial infrastructure set up in Oblivion. In the plains of Oblivion. So and a monk. I've been stabbing. Stab the legs out of that monk. Yes, it is. 225 gold. Of course, I cannot carry that because, well, I'm carrying too much gold to carry more gold. I don't know why I even bothered trying to loot bodies at this point, but I should probably stop doing that. Yeah. And that's it for this side. No more hidden parts. I will climb up onto this rock again and save. So one of the things that bugs me a lot is having to redo stuff. Okay, so I think we have come back to a certain point in the dungeon where we initially branched off from. And I do believe this leads back to the main area. Although, how did we enter going there though? Is what I wonder. Have we been to the rise? Is what I wonder. I think we have. Yes, we have. We came from there and we went there. So, let me just drop something here so that I don't get confused later. I think there was one pathway that I had not taken before. Oh, yeah, this one. I can see something right in front of me, but it's a mummy. With a monk in the background. Yeah, I probably shouldn't be bothered looting these guys. Yeah, what's the point? I mean, it's not that I'll be able to carry anything that they have. At least this area of the dungeon is lit, or of the deep system at least. Sure. Might as well. Resident dungeons and stuff. I wonder why I was given 27 entire days to finish this task. Seems a little odd to me, so. Okay, so did we go down there or not? I think we did. We did go down there. And we cleared that area out. And we cleared that area out. And we cleared this area out. Didn't we? I don't recall doing so. We went there as well. Is there any area remaining that we have not yet covered over here? I think not. I think not, but I think we have covered the entirety of this area. Except for this place, wherever that goes. But if we get into too much trouble, we'll of course be getting back to it. Usually, there are quest targets in these cages, so... You know what? Yeah. Wait, I can't? I was like, sit down, bitch. I should lay down. Drawing Chris. Of course I can't carry that. You know what? That actually looks nice. No, I'm gonna remove this. And I'm gonna equip this. Because this... Oh, it cannot be serious. I literally just removed it. How can I not? Oh my god. Okay. Let me drop like what? 100 pieces of gold there. Let me get this. Thank you. Now it looks more permanent. So I'm guessing that quadrant is done over here. Let's go ahead and raid the area in front of us. Let me go in the PVC. I see a wraith, and I kill a wraith. Of course that body has the treasure. Yeah, this is a dead end, nothing here. The only way forward is up. I like being strong enough to the point where even the difficult dungeon like this is just a leisurely stroll for me. And that is pretty much the charm of the old school little scroll leaps. Little scroll skips. Dungeon crawlers. At least. I mean, in Arena you could compensate by just buying hundreds upon hundreds of health potions and literally just burning through them as you go. In this game, it's different. Okay, there's nothing here, apparently. I can hear something, but apparently there's nothing here. Maybe I should go back there, you know, to that pit thing and check out what's on there. Because this area had nothing. Like, it was devoid of anything at all. So I guess this dungeon isn't as expansive as it seems. I sort of misled me into believing that it was larger than I thought it was. Can we? No, we can't really, can we? I mean... Yeah, there is something over here that we can check out. So, yeah, let me go ahead and save it. Because it's an easy way to die. Let me start by climbing up first, and... I can see a date rod, but I'm stuck on something. And I don't know how to get out of it. So... yeah, let's load the PVC. Climbing up into these areas is difficult. I think I should just use that potion of... This will take me down to the, you know, stone pebbles thing. Let me hit this area up first. As expected, it does nothing. Of course, I can't loot anything. Why did I even bother trying to? Nothing new. Maybe I can press. I took the beginning, of course. Save the game. Yeah, I'll save it here. In case things don't pan out for us. Which I doubt they would. I doubt things would pan out for us. But there are two objectives still that are still remaining, as far as I can tell. Let me use up the potion for the deep. Yep. Exactly what I want to do. Bishop. Gota. Bishop to go down. Fuck you, Vic. Yeah. I doubt you have any treasure on you, but even if you did, it would be sort of pointless for me to search because I don't carry any treasure on me, that is. Yeah, this is... So these are, there are some pieces like these that... Yeah, we have been here before. We have been down this route before. Or so it would have been to leave. Wait, how did that... How did I see that thing over there? Where did that thing come from? I'll get you. Don't slip me... Yeah, I thought I was gonna backstab that mummy, but apparently that was not possible. Why'd you even bother? I mean, it's not like I can carry any of this. Ooh, yay! This is the... Hi there! Maybe... Of course I got... I can try it. Yeah, let's use these. Of course it is. So then she uses them. So there's this guy down there that I need to... Did I thought it was down there. How did he come up here? What happened, can't you, like... So this should open up the trapdoor that we saw earlier. And now it's a matter of making our way all the way back there. I don't know which one to target first. This one or the one that's below me. What I do want to do, however, is... Okay, jump first. Now there are two of them down there. Oh no. Oh no. Let me save the game here first before I try any more shenanigans. It's gonna be rough. Where's the potion up? Right there. Yeah, that was rough. That was rough. But hey, I got two more kills, so that's nice. Or so I suppose. I can only go, right? So apparently So this was the skull which unlocked the previous dungeon's trapdoor, right? Hoping to see with this dungeon as well. But the problem is I don't know yet. Daedric's stealth and long wait all improved. Let's see even if it's not. So I made a conscious decision to come over onto this side of the quest, because otherwise it would have been not impossible to rest with them constantly screaming down my ears. So this door here. Oh, so this is where the other guy came from, right. So, this was also a colossal waste of time. Not precisely though, I think that the chapter might now be open. And we can go and check it out then. Probably could have done that a little more gently, but it is what it is. I do not suppose there are any more good doors here. I think the trapdoor was somewhere over here, if I'm not wrong. I regret coming up. Because, I mean, it was unnecessary bloodshed. It was not at all required, but this is some place that I might want to go up into. Just check what's up there. Because I don't... It seems like we have not been down there. Or... Maybe we have, actually. I think we just... We were just down there. Yeah, see? We were down there. Right, so we have already covered that area. Nothing there. I'm going to just search for Daedros to kill at this point. And we take the left up here. God, I'm getting good at navigating this game. This way? I think? I do not recall. But I think it was this one? No, not this one, no. We continue past this.
Yeah.
And we take a left. Actually, that's the... Wait a minute. Before I go there, I want to jump down onto that side as well, because I think we have not gone here yet. Or so I suppose. I have gotten to make a certain. Yeah, let me go and make a scene here. Let me override this here. Well, it seems we have been here. Never mind. Wrong save. Right, so let us go ahead and trapdoor is open. I can hear some of them down there, to be honest. I think I landed on one of them. Okay, time for you to die! Why do I even bother? I hope this is the last one. Because I'm running out of space, of course it was not. Ah, Daggerfall, why do you have to be such... so difficult? But seriously, it could have been so much easier, but they were like, no, we are going to be difficult. Because it suits our personality. Of course I can't bear any more stuff. I'm just gonna get into the mood. And will we see it with you? Mayhaps. I'll just see it here. And there were two Daedra down there as I predicted. Except that did not mark the end of the game. Or of this crusade anyway. So we'll have to keep going, unfortunately. What I am thankful for though is the fact that there are no vampires in the city. And since this is pretty much the only area where we can explore, and we have, you know, unexplored parts to this place, then I suppose this is pretty much the only area wherein we can actually, you know, find new places to, well, essentially explore and kill Daedra. Places where we have to jump down. Maybe we haven't been before. Areas like that. Like for example that area up there. Have we been up there? Is the question. And yeah, that is where we jumped down from. The trapdoor was on the other side of this, so this is the area we jumped down. I think. Yes, it was. Are there any hidden doors here? That we have not checked yet? I do not suppose so. Now then. We went up there, nothing here. Let's keep going down, let's keep checking, let's keep searching for any places that we might have forgotten to check before. For example, this hovel here, pyramid status. And this area was empty. Or rather, is empty right now. No longer a concern. To be precise. Can we climb this? No? These walls are climbable or something? Ah, thank you. There we go. And yeah, this is one of those areas where we have already planned before. Now, here is one place where I would like to. With the eyes of the law of Wayrest, I'm a common citizen. Except that I'm a knight. But I guess that does not make me impervious to anything. Actually, before I use this, I would like to save the game here. In case. Because I do not recall if. Opening this door was an easy feat. Um, Yeah, so this is how you open the door. My question is, have you been here before? I do not know where I am at this point anymore. It's difficult for me to tell, but judging from the fact that this door is open, I'm going to assume that we have. Oh yeah, so this is the area that we jumped down. So I'm guessing it was the other place where we had not been yet. Like, have you been? Oh yeah, we climbed out of here. So let's go ahead and is this the way? Or is this the way? I think that's the way. I can hear some enemies over here, but I can't locate where they are. There was another one of those areas, somewhere else in the dungeon. I guess we'll just have to walk around until we find them. Like, find that area where it's, maybe other enemies were, maybe they were older. That takes us down. I think this is one place that we've not been at. So if it's in. Let's go check it out then. Is this this? No, I do not think it is, because we have already been here. Yes. We can hear it all the way to the top. We were just here, right, I believe. Yes, we were down there, if I'm not wrong. Oh, the underwater area, right. I doubt there would be any daytrot over there, but let's backtrack our steps in. Let's see where else we can go. The underwater area is remaining for one. And then there should also be that other area. Where was that area? I wonder. I'm pretty sure we will find it once we get back. Like, once we start going back. Here's this. Just this one down here. We have already been there, there was nothing there. Like, there was another one of these areas on this side of the map. I just forgot where it was. Is it there? Yes, it is here. So how do we get there then? So I suppose what we need to do here is we keep going up. And then we take a left and a U-turn. We keep going up to here, and then we take a right at the big stone, and we reach this area, and we keep. No, that does not take us there. So we take a left at the big stone, and the path leads straight to it. Let's go up, take a left at the big stone. Something. I'm not sure what it was that I heard, but I heard something. There are certainly enemies here, that much is a guarantee. So I'll first go down, then I'll use the left spell to come up. That was sort of creepy, that laugh, whatever that was. I'll go over at the safe. I still haven't found, like, Hi, mummy. Is that mummies? I tend to attack mummies before they get like a single shot off. So yeah, it's a bit sort of sad that it is the way it is. And there's like an entire subsystem over here. Oh, hi there. Would you care to die? Why do you even bother when I know that I can't like pick up any of the gold? Of course I got rescued, but this log has nothing to fear for me. Before I bash in the block next door, because I can. Okay, this place seems a little different bit. Let me go ahead and explore this door though. Okay, I was exploring that door. Right. So instead of going here, I decided to go here. Fine. So there's like a tunnel down there. And I will be taking it, just not yet. These are decorative skulls, they do not have any meaning to them. Let's go down. I wonder how we even managed to like access this area without the use of any levitation spells or anything. It is like a copy of the entire same watch room, but in a different direction. A higher rate, but you're not really what I'm looking for. What I'm looking for is something far more violent than, you know, a simple. This should be a secret door. Yeah, again, I'm not gonna kill this one because it is unnecessary. Okay. Now it's necessary. Now it's just making necessary because this one had a bow and arrow. I mean, you could have been stayed alive inside that beach, but then but you chose to die. You literally chose to die instead. It's like a copy of the entire module. The same entire module. The second entire copy of it. Yeah, let's explore this module. Let's see what this module has to offer. Of course, this door is locked. Sorry, what did not be? There's a mummy here. Not what I'm looking for. Absolutely not what I'm looking for. Why do I even bother? Oh wait, I can still pick up some food at least. But nothing else really. Just some gold is all that I picked up. This is where the door should have been. I did not really need to sleep there, but I just did anyway. After we finish exploring this area, we will go ahead and explore the other side. And maybe let's take a bottom-up approach this time around. Let's jump down there first. Let's see what all it has to offer. Somebody tossed. I see you. I see you. Hold up. I'll come get you. Who's the deal with this monk? And probably mummy or a wraith or something back there. Ooh, another one of your deal drops. Successful backstab. Good job. This one didn't have anything. I'll come get you if you just wait right there. Wait, where's that? Yeah, right here, right? Somewhere over here. Another day drop. So there was this entire segment of the map that we did not know about. Alright, I'm coming for you. You're still there. You're not. Ah, yeah. See, that's pretty much what I don't like about this game sometimes. Sometimes the target will just disappear. But typically, I would be dropping markers and stuff. And this is the only way to do this, but yeah. Did that tree just duck? Wait, did that create me a duck sweep or something? These guys are hitting hard! Is it because I've been silenced or something? I see you. I cast my eyes on you and I will assault you. Just you wait. Okay, I need a place to rest. Is that a bat or a dragon thing? That is definitely a dragon thing. Because otherwise it would not take as many hits for it to die. Of course it does not have any treasure. Another dragon thing, no! Aren't you flying enemy? Can't you like fly over to me? Come on! What's got rage attacks? Why would these shivers? Don't be a stranger, come on. Yeah, there is like a upgrade there. It's sort of like. Sort of like, unless you walk to these gates first, they won't walk towards you. Like, sorry, the sea trunk. And I would assume that means everything here is cleared. Again, gold for you. Not that I would actually go and try to get it. But it's good to know that there's some gold there. So, I more or less know this dungeon module quite well, being the reason why I'm taking it so recklessly, because I have explored this quite meticulously in the search for letters. Otherwise, I probably would not have been so reckless with this hunt. Because I had to scour every inch of this place with these modules to try and find the letter. It's like the more you play this game, the more you become familiar with it, and I think you can see that for absolutely any game out there. Yeah, no point in bothering to loot. We're not looting more. We are over encumbered as is. Okay, there's like an entire different cave system over there or something. Okay, maybe we. Oh, so that's what the engine brought you here. Does it connects the two places. I see. So we will get to you later. Until then, I'll just stay here. I'll make a save here. Actually, I should probably make the route to save instead. In case I might want to access this later. So that's where I came from. This is. Yeah, where the secret room was. This is typically where there would be like another level, but in this case, there's like the entrances module is here. I mean, procedural generation was a huge part of the games, but at the same time, they also used to generate stuff by hand. Okay, so both of you died. That's good. That's really good for me. And then where did it go? Yeah, it follows the structure of this. What the fuck is that? Better not be like a. Oh, like a greater deer drop. Because that would be bad. I can hear the person that's laughing, but that person's behind. These guys honestly look like Argonians, to be honest, more than Daedrons. I'm pretty sure that if I want to activate... Ah, there you are. So I'm pretty sure that if I want to activate spell effect... I feel like I'm being touched by Pelagius. With all the laughing and singing and merrymaking. Oh, come on, fine, already. You know what? Fine. If it is Pelagius... wait, was it Pelagius or was it the name something else? I forgot the name, actually. The Mad God. Pelagius, I think, is a Mad King, but not a Mad God, so... I think I'm confusing the names here a little bit. This is unlocked. Of course, it has nothing. So, this will probably, you know, set that door to where it's easier to open. And this might have some data of it, being one of the reasons why I'm choosing to break it open. Of course, it is not. It has. Looks like the monks got tired of me banging on the door and they decided to open it from within. I'm guessing they were just protecting themselves from the data. As well. 32 gold pieces at least I can pick that up, but nothing else. I would love for a place to rest. Maybe in here. With my back to the door, of course. Remove. I'll just save here. And yeah. So now to find where we can essentially. Oh, yeah, we haven't gone to the left yet, have we? Oh no, that's a greater Daedrot. That is what I was fearing. That is exactly what I was fearing. No. That's what I could hear laughing all this while. Wait, are there two of them? That looks like Thor. Do I have another? I hope I have another. Oh, I have two more. Good. Daedra just died. I don't know what Daedra this is, but this is certainly not an easy arena. I need to be very careful. Good thing I have one last potion of being true, because otherwise this encounter is going to be very, very difficult for me. Extremely difficult. Oh, good thing I got more. Daedra Lord. Whew. I actually managed to do that. I actually managed to kill them. I like that. I like that fact. I really do like that fact. Wait, is that another Daedra Lord? Oh, hell no. Oh, hell no. I'm not fighting him right now, no. What I'm gonna do instead is I'm gonna run like a bitch and I'm gonna rest here. Where's the enemy? That's supposed to be near me. Okay, I'm gonna save the game here in this dedicated slot and I'm gonna go back to it. I'm gonna get back to it and I'm gonna fight these guys. Oh wait, wrong turn. There you are. So I guess that was the enemy that came to check on me. Whew. Intense, intense. Those guys were intense. Duator Lord and Frost Duator. I feel drained. Probably draining my Magicka. Let me go ahead and use my final potion of heal food. I did it again. It's like a hat trick. Let us not chase it. I'm just gonna. Yeah, I'm gonna find a place to rest here. That was difficult, my god. Those two encounters were really difficult. I was not anticipating them to be this difficult. We should do it. Yeah, this guy looks like a fish rat. Whatever that was. But I'm guessing my Daedra killing gates aren't over yet because I haven't been notified as of yet. Let it be a normal one, please. Thank you. I would take you over something as crazy as a Daedra lot. Oh no. Voice from beyond echoes in your head saying, "The last Daedra is dead with it." Oh my god, yes, thank you. The last Daedra is dead. With it dead, tampering the sieve again. Hey, what are you doing? Let go of my arms. I'm the Guild Mage. Don't blow out that. Wait, what? Okay, I see any more? I'm running past them. I'm not stopping to engage. Oh no. No sirree. I mean, I think this is the point where having like a recall spell would have been amazing, but since we are a warrior, we don't do spells. At least we can use potions though. So following what we do. Yes, and water walking would be good. Okay, let's do this. I'm hoping I'm going the right way. Yeah, I do not want to engage any of you guys in combat. Why am I stuck here? Am I like stuck on some enemy or something? Oh no. Let me reload this emergency save here. I mean, I do have some potions of levitation still. I could probably try and levitate my way out of here. I think that would be a much better solution than going through the water. Oh no. Well, at least I can still levitate up and down, even though I'm stuck in a wall. That was not the correct place to do that. Okay, I'm gonna reload this image to see. And we're gonna take our time finding the proper way to levitate out of this little hovel of ours that we've dug ourselves into. See, now despite knowing this area as well as I do, I still don't know how to get out of here, so. Yeah. That's just how it works. I think we need to go down there, yes. So how do we reach there, this question? Question begins with, where are we now? And we head up there, and then we go down there. And then we keep going down. Right. I think I have an idea. Like, I have a fair idea about where to go. Better to move cautiously than to rush to our death. This is where we came out of, so this is where we should be going. I made the decision of climbing down first, and I think that was a good decision because that way. Yeah, I think we're safe now because we have already cleared these areas out. I do not anticipate any more, you know, danger logs trying to come and kill me. So, yeah. This was a good raid, this was a good raid indeed. I like this dungeon raid, to be honest, and yeah, that's not something I thought I would find myself saying, but I did like this dungeon raid. Yeah, I had a good idea, I guess. I think so. Yeah, we like go down there, and then here then. We keep heading there to the entrance, yes. And since I've already cleared out all of these areas before, it doesn't really... There's no limit of danger anymore. So, yay! I returned successful to the Knights Guild. No, I do not. I have these statue lies in the dust. Let's go back to Wayrest. That is some anxious music. Yes, I do. Yeah, ships don't travel on the land. Well, I mean, given the fact that the game is really 70s to complete this, and I complete this in about like a matter of just a few days, I would say that I've done like a good job at it. And I'm proud of it. I did not expect myself to become so strong as to be able to complete quests like this without any issues. But here we are. I mean, the first time it's fought Daedra, Frost Daedra, I could heat lead the floor with me. That's what happened. And, I mean, this time around I killed, like, what? Two Daedra Lords and two Frost Raiders. That's a pretty monumentous achievement for me, if I say so myself. Enemy scaling is pretty much the only thing about this game that is a little, you know, needs a little work. But yeah. So, turns out that maybe this mission was not all that well authorized. We'll have to go and confirm now at the Knights Guild, but yeah. Really? What's the time right now? 7, so we need to wait for like 4 hours outside. 3 hours at a time, so 3 hours now, 1 hour late. I think that there are no assassins being sent after me at this moment. Oh, right. Ah, just as I said that. Where are you? Come on out. Show yourself. Show yourself. Where are you? Oh, right. No, that's... No? Why? Yeah, I guess I'll take that punishment. This is still needless, yes. Yeah, good thing we got 47 days. Alright. I am undependable in the eyes of law, of course I am. Why would I not be? So apparently it is illegal to camp outside of cities, and the game, but wow, this game, the scenery looks lovely right now, to be honest. I should enter from that side more often. What is the time right now? 14? Yeah, good thing that they gave me like 27 days, because otherwise I probably would have missed the deadline because of this one mistake. And would have had to reload the game. A knight. A goddamn knight arrested for being, so can you believe that? And the worst part of it is, the game didn't even let me rest inside. Like, the game just said, yeah, it's illegal to rest, but it didn't even let me rest outside. So you killed the Daedra, eh? Actually, this is kind of embarrassing. As it turns out, that we were duped by a rogue mage. She had summoned a Daedra that she could not control and wanted us to slay it before the guild found out. Oh no. No wonder. She thought that with her story, we would do it for free rather than having to pay the fighter's guild. Normally, our order does not pay its members for their trouble. This is an unusual situation. Take these 457 gold pieces. But the problem is, they were like, oh my god. At least I have my wagon put, you know, stuff into for the time being, I suppose. Yeah, so now that gives me some space to take some more gold off this guy. And yeah, that's that. And that is quite literally that. I hope that getting arrested did not ruin the reputation. Even if it did, there's nothing I can do about it. So yeah, that was it for me today, to be honest. I thought about doing back-to-back dungeon crawling quests, but yeah, I don't have the energy in me right now. So yeah, I'll get back to you guys as I'll record another session tomorrow, and I'll get back to you guys accordingly. Until then, I'll see you later. That's a great quest. Huh. I've just gotten word of a giant raiding farms and devouring cattle. My name? Thousand Bomb, peace, Grimfangs. I'm a victim of Buckingcroft. I have met you quite a few times. I would not be asking you for your name. Why is my character asking for his name? And I don't think I did. Anyway, will you go slay the giant? That's it? Okay, raiding farms and devouring cattle. Okay. The giant has made a den out of the roost of Grimulus. Ah, no wonder. Go there and kill them. You might find other giants there. Kill them if you must, but be sure to get the one with the bear claw branded on his arm. I can only give it 27 days. Right. So I was wondering, how is a knight's guild quest so simple that we can just waltz into a field and get it done with? Okay, Roost of Grimulus. Travel time 3 days, of course we can't travel past my ship. Should I use the... Nah, I think I'll switch over to something else. Oh, by the way, I got a key. I was missing one. Got like a good place. No, not there. Yeah, in the back, and I was about to lose the sword, my god. Yeah, maybe we should... let's check here. What... primary... Yeah, I think it's my axe that's most lacking, so might as well just go ahead and upgrade the axe. Although that is also the most under-leveled. like, it's the least powerful of them all. 8 to 18, 11 to 22, and 13 to 24. Yeah, let's use this instead. So the entrance should be somewhere, I think the classy entrance right there. Let me go and make a save. Should I pull this out first? Okay, I can see two parts. There are three parts, of course. Three parts is there too, it's obviously. Which way do we go first? This seems familiar, to be honest. I think I've been here before. Unless it's just this module. Let us try going left, I guess? Okay. Ah, yes, the underwater area. I hear something flying. It's a harpy. Will it be attacking me? I think not. I think I've successfully defused the situation by speaking in harpy. I mean, harpy's not attacking me, so I can only assume that to be the case. Ah, now you're trying to attack me. Alright. I'm guessing that the harpy is just not up to anything at that point in time. Yeah, I'll take it and do this. It's the underwater area, we'll be going back here later in case we can't find. The chance is not going to be in an underwater area, no point in going there. Yeah, no need to save for me. No need to save yet, as no need for me to save, excuse me. I can't even reach today, yet again. No surprise there. Another harpy. Okay, it's a. It's just a linear corridor, nothing else. But for two pieces. Oh, I completely forgot to drop a. Yeah, I'll drop it the next time around. Yeah. Well, I couldn't exactly see any videos on the route, so I'm going to assume that they burn them. Let's keep moving. I still don't see any hidden doors, so I'm gonna bring it just so that they don't know. Yeah. I heard a door opening. And I can hear some harpies. Question is, was there like a hidden door here? It's a good idea to keep checking the map. I see something on the left. Oh no, it's scorpions. A lot of scorpions. And I just realized that. Oh yeah, I do have potions of free action at least. Just as I mentioned about. Wand of lightning. Oh yeah, I do have a piece of wand of lightning. Blazing wrap of fireballs. I actually got this stuff, the wrap that I got last time, that was like a wrap of fireballs. So I think I could use that. Where is it? Free action? That's what I'm looking for, right? A beer claw brand is clearly visible on the upper arm of the champ. This must be the one I picked to Bucklecroft spoke of. Alright then, I guess that's my job then. Should I save you? Might as well. In case there's some more trouble ahead. I mean, this was a short tour. Every time I enter a dungeon in this game, I look pray for, like, a low key pray for an experience like this. But, yeah, but when I do get an experience like this at times, I wish that it maybe could have been longer because. It's like a sweet spot for exploring a dungeon, and
Being a knight really has its perks. For example, I've got only 11 gold pieces on me. Sorry, 77 gold pieces on me. Excuse me. Yeah, had to clear my throat there. I still have a throat infection going on. Not like exactly an infection per se, just like, I have a sore throat. Yeah, but it cost me 0 gold. I mean, before this, it would have cost me an arm and then, like it would not have been possible for me to travel like this, so, yeah. My stealth skill has improved. I am undependable, of course. I mean, it happened last time around. I accidentally rested outside. Mistake I hope I won't be making again. Which way do I need to go again? Straight. I mean, the game didn't even let me rest, but it still arrested me for resting outside anyway. A knight being arrested for vagrancy, of all things. I mean, the guy literally has lodging in any inn he wants to across the Iliad Bay for no cost. No cost at all. But still, he gets arrested for vagrancy. Can you imagine that? A knight, brother, at that. It's not just like an initiate in a knightly order, a knight brother of your region getting arrested for vagrancy. It's a farce, is what it is. Alright, Vega. Time for me to get out of the stage. And what time is it again? Of course. Loiter carefully. The thing is, even if you rest for like 0 hours, it still counts as resting. I mean, even if you just press the rest button right, it still counts as resting, so you need to be like really careful of what you press. Any enemies there? None that I can see. Good. Day is pretty overcast today. I wonder what happened there. Okay, let's talk to Elepictor Buckingcroft. Now you're a true giant, Killer Grimfangs. And to think I got to shake your hand. Really, no. Now why is Elepictor simping for me, I wonder? Let me just go and save you. Yeah, let me talk to this guy again. Yes, so this is what I was waiting for. I was wondering if I would need to do 3 quests or 2 quests. Turns out 2 quests was more than enough. For meritorious service and unswerving loyalty to the ideals of the Knights of the Rose, you have been awarded the title of Commander within the Order. As a symbol of your fellow knights' estimation, we have elected to present you with a new piece of armor. You also have access to the ships reserved for our order, so you need never again have to pay for passage across the bay. I offer you my personal congratulations, Commander Grimfangs. So, do I get a ship or is traveling on ships free? Is my question. Yeah, I don't want to get a quest from you right now. I mean, I would like to go for the quest, but yeah, not really. A fine piece of armor for me, which has been added to my inventory, apparently. Let me go check it out. Oh. It's a dwarven cuirass. Not like the one I already had before. I completely forgot. I need to remove the bow and arrow from my inventory as well. Yeah. So, this thing is like a wrap, and let me just take it off. Yeah, so this thing is like a wrap, and it's a wrap of fireballs. So, like, I can literally cast fireball when I'm wearing it. Okay, let's go ahead and sell this. And yeah, as for you guys, all I'll say is that was, for me, it was a pretty short thing. I mean, we had a long adventure the last time around, but this time around for you guys, it was a pretty short adventure. Nothing too long. I mean, I guess for you guys, it is a bit long adventure. For me, it was a short one. So. Yeah, that's it for this video. We have been promoted to the rank of Knight Commander. I don't know why I'm having difficulty speaking, maybe it's all this decoration. But yeah, you have been promoted to the rank of Knight Commander, and wait, I just wanted to check something out. Is this better looking, or is this better looking? I can't tell, to be honest.
Three hours later.
So, I guess I'll just keep this for now and sell this off. Oh, really? This guy's giving me like less than half the gold that it's worth. I guess I'll be increasing my personality next time around. So anyway, yeah, this is the end of the video. We set out to be a... well, you know, promotion, and we got the promotion of Knight Commander, which I hope is the next rank up. I'm not entirely certain, to be honest, and I think it is the next rank up. Let me just go and check, confirm once. So that is a positive, despite our incarceration, or maybe the fine that we had to suffer fine to both our bank and our reputation. We are actually a nice brother. We gained one rank instead of like 4 or 5 ranks, like what happened the first time around, but yeah. I digress. This is it for today. Thank you for tuning in, thank you for watching, and thank you for sticking around until the end. When we come back next time, we will be taking on the Fighters World Guild quests. Until then, take care. Fare thee well, fellow workers.